A meniscus repair athletic rehab program is going to have pretty similar exercises, although it's going to be over a much longer time span, as you will see at the end. So phase one, a range of motion, is going to occur 0 to 2 weeks post-operation. The goals of range of motion is to reduce swelling, minimize pain, to restore patellar mobility and restore full extension and flexion is less than 90 degrees, and to reestablish quad control and regain full active extension. Some exercises to help meet these goals include ankle pumps, as seen here, assisted knee flexion, and prone hang, although you should avoid active knee flexion in the beginning to prevent a strain. This is a prone knee hang in the back, and the criteria to progress from phase one is knee extension range of motion at 0 degrees, knee flexion range of motion at 90 degrees, quad contraction with superior patella glide and full active extension, and the ability to perform a straight leg raise without lag. Phase two is strengthening and is going to happen 3 to 5 weeks post-operation. The goals of this are to continue to protect and repair, to reduce pain and minimize swelling, and to maintain full extension, and to get flexion less than 120 degrees. Some exercises to help meet these goals are calf raises, as seen on the previous slide, clamshells, and two legs on a wobble board or Eric's pad or another type of balancing device. The criteria to progress from this stage is no swelling, which can be tested in a modified stroke test, flexion range of motion at 120 degrees, and extension range of motion equal to the contralateral side or the uninjured leg. Phase three is proprioception and occurs 6 to 8 weeks post-operation. The goals of proprioception are to continue to protect, repair, and maintain full extension as well as normalized gait, flexion within 10 degrees of the contralateral side, promote proper movement patterns to avoid post-exercise pain and swelling, and at this point, an athlete can discontinue the use of the brace crutches after 6 weeks by a medical advice. Some exercises to help meet these goals are a partial squat, as seen on the previous slide, and is not down to the full 90 degrees, only 0 to 60. Wall slides, as seen on this slide, and prone hamstring curls, which will be seen on the next slide. The criteria to progress from phase three includes no swelling or pain after exercising, a normal gait, and a range of motion equal to the contralateral side. Phase four is plyometrics and occurs 9 to 12 weeks post-operation. The goals of phase four are to maintain full range of motion, safely progress strengthening, promote proper movement patterns, and avoid post-exercise pain and swelling. Some exercises to help meet these goals are squat to chair, lateral lunges, and Romanian deadlift. And although some of these pictures will have the athletes using weight, the patient should always progress from no weight to more weight, similar to progressing from a double leg squat to a single leg squat. The criteria to progress from this phase is no episodes of instability, a maintenance of quad strength, 10 repetitions of a single leg squat with proper form through at least 60 degrees of knee flexion, and a functional assessment will be done. Phase five is sports specifics or functional and will occur 3 to 5 months post-operation. The goals of phase five are to safely progress strengthening, safely initiate sports specific training program, to promote proper movement patterns, and of course, avoid post-exercise pain and swelling. Some exercises to meet these goals will be sprints with a sudden change of direction, sprints with sudden stops, and single leg jumps for distance. And when considering returning to play, an athlete should always progress with playing by themselves, playing with one other person, playing with three other people, etc., until they feel comfortable and it's safe for them to return. The criteria to progress from this stage is a clearance from a medical doctor, and all milestone criteria below have been met. They should complete a jog or run program without pain and swelling and will have a functional assessment. This is a comparison between the two rehab programs, and as you can see, a meniscectomy only takes about 7 weeks, whereas a meniscus repair is going to take up to 20 weeks. This is a crazy difference, and it's even crazier when you consider that a meniscectomy sounds like it would contribute to a longer rehab program.